Study. This UV light type could kill coronavirus, yet safest to use around people. Scientists know that ultraviolet light can kill microbes on surfaces, in the air, and in water. But how can we use it against COVID-19 without risking people? According to an expert in UV disinfection, there's a type of UV that can do the job. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. In the conversation, environmental engineering and UV disinfection expert Carl Linden of the University of Colorado Boulder explained how UV kills pathogens. Light is distinguished by wavelength, and UV has wavelengths between 100 and 400 nanometers, shorter than violet hues in visible light. Shorter wavelengths mean the photons of light have more energy. However, not all UV types can eliminate microbes. Remember, UV-generating devices and sunlight aren't bombs that can wipe out organisms in a blink of an eye. The chance of a virus getting killed by UV is based on how much of the wavelengths its genetic matter has absorbed. Published in ASM journals, Linden and his colleagues sought UV wavelengths that could kill microbes but not harm the human body. They tested the 5 most commonly used UV types on SARS-CoV-2. They tested how much UV light is required to kill 90% to 99.9% of the viral particles. The test included UV LEDs with 270 to 282 nanometers light emission, traditional UV tube lamps with 254 nanometers emission, and the newer excimer UV source with 222 nanometers emission. These devices were trialed in a water sample spiked with millions of SARS-CoV-2 viruses. Researchers also coated a Petri dish with a thin layer of that mixture. While all UV emissions could kill the virus at low doses, the wavelength of 222 nanometers was the lowest dose that could kill 99.9% of viral particles. One calculation showed it could disinfect a space in 20 seconds. The same light emission was deemed safe for humans for up to an hour and 20 minutes. It is still better to clear an entire area first before UV disinfection takes place. But if incidents are expected, the 222 nanometers emission seems to give a grace period. Perhaps it is applicable in busy areas where people constantly move in and out. What's your take about using UV disinfection? Are you comfortable if such technology is deployed in your workplace? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.